You can feel like everything's just caving in around you. I had OD'd. I had been to prison. Originally from Texas. Was in an abusive relationship there. It felt like a repetitive cycle. I kept going through something, you know, and kept becoming homeless. I was living in my car. I mean, everything was just so overwhelming. And got here on a bus and ended up staying at Bethany House.
One of the things that I was just thinking about as we were getting in the car is the fact that Rives Neighborhood, so this community around the Catholic Charities programs, is the most impoverished community in all of Terre Haute. In fact, across the board, surpass the state averages for percentage of individuals who are in poverty, for those who are unemployed, for those who are food insecure. So the residents that are here are really still facing a community that hasn't completely come out of the Great Recession from 2008. So Bethany House is an emergency shelter. It is meant to be a short-term shelter program. Our typical stay used to be about 60 days or so. Because of COVID, of course, that's increased a lot. But our whole intent is not our average stay is 60 days, so therefore at 60 days you have to leave, right? It's really to bring people in and to work with them. We do a lot of case management, so understanding where people are in their life, what led them to becoming homeless, and helping them to set goals and work through their goals to get to that next point in their life, which we hope to be self-sufficiency.
I grew up around the church, and then I backslid, and then I went back, you know, into all kinds of other things, and had to have my own spiritual journey. I stayed there for 30 days. I learned goal setting, money management, things like budgeting, learning how to get a job.
We do have a job search board over here. So again, opportunities for our residents to be able to, you know, find a job, because that's the goal. Long term is that people are able to leave Bethany House and get back up on their own feet.
Come in with certain situations, and you know, you just deal with it. And they taught me not only that within my own self and my own life, but to help the other women that actually come in. So I have a lot to give back to them, because there's no excuses. The girls come in and they try to give me excuses, and I'm like, no, if you heard my story, you would understand. And several of them has had the opportunity to hear my story, and they're like, wow, you know, there's no reason why I can't get out there and get a job and get, you know, on my feet and everything, if you could do that and with the obstacles that you had. Now I'm the citizen that's being able to give back.
I think Jennifer's interview was phenomenal in that she could tell her story and then relate to us, like, how that's changed how she works with others, and the compassion then and empathy that she can show to others, but also how she can say, now look, this is how I was able to do it, and encourage those individuals who are in similar situations that, yes, even as hard as it is today, there is a light at the end of the tunnel, and you can get there too. If I was able to do it, you can do that too. And so I think that's just one of the huge blessings of being able to find somebody like Jennifer who is able to do that on her own with some help and support. But you know what? Our staff can't do it for our residents. Our residents have to have the desire and the will to be able to do that on their own. And Jennifer did that. And so being able to share her story then with others, I think just gives that encouragement that they may also need to be able to do that on their own.
That's what I wanted to say about Bethany House and Catholic Charities. And they embraced me, even though I had my background and everything that I had gone through, they still embraced me and still accepted me, you know, right where I was at. I'm grateful. That's all I have is gratitude.